Radiology. It's about knowing anatomy and recognizing changes in the normal appearance of structures. Nowhere is this as critical as it is when interpreting a mammogram. Breast anatomy is very basic. There are only a few main structures that you need to know. The borders of the breast consist primarily of skin, the pectoralis muscle posteriorly, and the nipple areolar complex anteriorly. The inframammary fold is the area where the breast meets up against the chest wall inferiorly. The breast is composed primarily of fatty tissue with a varying amount of fibroglandular tissue. If you dive a little bit deeper into the anatomy, you have a branching network of ducts that start at the nipple and course back through the breast. You have main ducts that branch to smaller and smaller ducts, ultimately culminating in the terminal ducts. The terminal ducts lead to the lobule. The lobule is the area within the breast where milk is made. These structures together are called the terminal ductal lobular unit. And this is a very important structure where most breast pathology occurs within the major ducts. You can have ductectasia where the duct is dilated. Cysts can form off of the main duct. Papillomas are also very common intraductal masses. And lastly, ductal carcinoma in situ can present and spread throughout the main lactiferous ducts. If it's close to the nipple, this is Paget's disease. The terminal ducts are where most of the action occurs. Hyperplasia, or overgrowth of normal cells, can occur. This is usual ductal hyperplasia. If the cells are abnormal, it's called atypical ductal hyperplasia. Papillomas can occur in these smaller terminal ducts. And then ductal carcinoma, which can be ductal carcinoma in situ if it's all confined within the duct, or if it breaks free from the myoepithelial layer of the terminal duct, it is referred to as invasive ductal carcinoma. The lobules are at the end of the terminal duct. This is where milk is made. Cysts very frequently form within the lobule. Fibroadenomas occur within the lobule. Adenosis can occur in the lobule. And lastly, lobular carcinoma. And this is a spectrum ranging from atypical lobular hyperplasia to lobular carcinoma in situ and invasive lobular carcinoma. Surrounding the lobule, you have some supporting structures known as extralobular stroma. Within the extralobular stroma, you can have a few fairly uncommon breast pathologies such as radial scars, angiosarcoma, or liposarcoma. In contrast to many radiologic studies, in breast imaging, the biggest challenge is often simply recognizing whether the tissue is normal or abnormal. Thank you for watching. Please click subscribe to see more of our content, or go to MAMMOGUIDE.COM to learn more about breast imaging.